If you've got a yellow warning light on your Synology NAS right now, take a deep breath. We're about to turn this potential disaster into an upgrade. Not only will we save our precious data from impending doom, but we're also going to add a few terabytes of capacity while we're at it. So stick around. So let me set the stage. I recently found that the status lights on my Synology NAS had changed from the usual happy green to a concerning yellow. Never a good sign. So I looked in the web management tool and found that one of the drives was having problems and would likely be failing soon. You might also be tipped off to coming problems if you start noticing unusually slow performance, read-write errors, or strange noises like clicking sounds coming from the NAS. Now I'll admit that my heart skipped a beat when I thought about all those important files and photos that were at risk. But I spent a few decades working in IT, and I've replaced plenty of RAID drives. So I know that it's actually not that difficult to fix, and it's a perfect opportunity to expand the capacity of our NAS. Mine is the Synology DS216 Play, which is a two-drive NAS that's been rock solid for me for 8 years. But 8 years is really pushing the limits of a hard drive's expected lifespan, so it shouldn't really be that surprising that they're starting to have problems. So today we'll walk through the process of replacing both drives with larger ones so that we can rescue our data and give us more space. Let's dive in. First, let's take a closer look at what we're dealing with. In the Synology DSM interface, inside Storage Manager, we can see one of the drives showing a warning indicator. It's kind of like the drive is giving us 2 weeks' notice that it's about to retire. If we only want to fix the problem, then we could get away with just replacing the failing drive with the same size replacement. But since both drives are that old, it really makes sense to replace them both. And I decided to go with a couple of 6 TB Western Digital RED drives as replacements for the old 4 TB Seagate Iron Wolf drives. Synology has a compatibility tool on their website that can tell you exactly what drive sizes and models are supported in your Synology NAS. So check that first before you go shopping for drives. And it's important to understand that we'll be replacing one drive at a time. This allows the NAS to rebuild the RAID after each replacement without losing data. You should never replace both drives simultaneously unless data loss is your hobby. By the way, I'm using Synology Hybrid RAID with 2 drives, which basically just mirrors the 2 drives like RAID 1. But there are several other possible RAID configurations, especially with the larger NAS units with 4 or more drive bays. But the same basic step should apply to those situations too. We're going to need to deactivate the failing drive, physically replace the drive, and then add that new drive into the RAID. And one more critical step. While I'm confident in this procedure, we should always have backups of our important data before performing any RAID maintenance. And remember that RAID is not a substitute for having good backups. RAID won't help us if the building burns down, and RAID won't help us if we accidentally overwrite a critical file. Now, before we actually replace the bad drive, we first need to deactivate it in the admin tool, basically to let the NAS know that we're about to replace that drive. In Storage Manager, we can see the details on the drive we want to replace, including its failing status and its serial number. Grab a screenshot of this page or jot down the serial number, because that'll help us to make sure we don't accidentally pull the wrong drive. Then we select Deactivate Drive from the Action menu, confirm that we really want to do that, and enter the admin password just to be extra sure. Hear that? The NAS starts beeping to alert you that it's in a degraded state. It seems to be designed to be just annoying enough that you can't ignore it, but not quite annoying enough to hit it with a hammer. At this point, I need to power down my NAS to open the case and replace the drive. But you may not need to do that if your model has hot swappable drives that slide out the front. If so, you can use the Locate Drive button in Storage Manager to have the NAS flash the LED on that drive, or change its color, to help identify the correct drive. Once the NAS is powered down, mine just has a couple of screws on the back that hold the cover in place. Remove those, and the cover slides off the front to expose the 2 hard drives inside. I'm replacing drive 1, which is the one on top, and I'll confirm that by checking the serial number. Then there are just 4 more screws that hold the drive in place, and it just slides out. The replacement drive then slides right into the same spot, and we use the same 4 screws to secure the drive in place. We'll temporarily put the cover back on, then power back up. Back in Storage Manager, we still have a critical status, but we can see that the new drive is recognized. Now we just need to add that drive into the storage pool, and it'll start repairing itself. We go to the storage pool and then click the Repair Now button to start. It'll then show us a list of all the available drives, and we can choose our new 6 TB drive and continue. We'll click through a few confirmations and warnings, then it'll initialize the drive, stop the alarm beeping, and start copying all of the existing data from drive 2 onto the new drive 1 so that we'll get our redundancy back. Now this is where patience comes in, because depending on how much data you have, this could take anywhere from several hours to several days. You could go watch the entire Lord of the Rings trilogy and still come back to find it at 63%. One way you can speed things up is to move your data off the NAS ahead of time so that it won't have as much to copy. And since I already have multiple backups of my data, I did just that, leaving only about 50 gigabytes of stuff on the NAS. So the rebuild should go very quickly in my case. And while I go watch Lord of the Rings anyway, please give us a like if you're getting something out of this video and consider subscribing to the channel. Alright, so after about 20 minutes, the rebuild is just finishing, and the system now shows a green, healthy status. You might notice, however, that the size of the storage pool remains the same as before, even though we added a larger drive. RAID arrays are typically limited to the size of the smallest drive, so we won't see the capacity increase until we replace the second drive, which is what we'll do now. The steps are exactly the same as before, so I'll zip through this one pretty quickly. We now deactivate drive 2 to remove it from the storage pool. Then we power down the NAS and replace drive 2 with another new 6TB drive. We go back into Storage Manager and click Repair Now on the storage pool. We select the new drive 2, begin the long rebuild process, and then go watch the entire Lord of the Rings trilogy again while we're waiting. This time, however, as the repair finishes, you should see the size of the storage pool expand right before your eyes. What was a little less than 4TB has now grown to a little less than 6TB. By the way, that little less is partially due to the way drive sizes are calculated, but using RAID also consumes a small portion of the space in order to make things work. So 6TB ends up being closer to 5.5. We've now got our bad drive replaced, a couple extra terabytes of storage, and all green lights in DSM and on the physical NAS. Plus, I even tidied up the equipment and cables in my closet while I was at it. So we're back in business and ready to fill up that new space with more cat videos. Thanks for watching, and please like and subscribe for more tech videos like this one. And if you stuck around this long, you might like my video on converting an old forgotten Mac Mini into a home storage and media server. See you next time.